Hi, welcome to a new Azure vlog. In this one, I would like to talk about Azure Sentinel again. In my previous vlog, you saw how we set up a Azure Sentinel workspace, connect it to the Azure Active Directory, and have some data in our workspace. Azure Sentinel is a SIEM solution, a security information and event management solution. So we want to get alerts when something is happening in our environment. In this vlog, I will show you how you can get alerts out of your data that's in Azure Sentinel. So let's grab a cup of coffee and I'll show you how you can set up alerts with Azure Sentinel. Okay, so have a look at this Azure Sentinel workspace. I made sure that the Windows Security Event Connector is enabled and configured. I also made sure that there was a virtual machine connected to the Log Analytics workspace that's used by this Azure Sentinel workspace. So let's have a look at the security data that's in there now. If we go to logs and search for security events, let's limit the amount of entries that will be returned to 100. We run that query. We'll see that there is a lot of data in there. And it's most all of the event 4625 account failed to log in. My Windows server has a public IP address and RDP is enabled. There are no firewalls that block the remote desktop protocol, so everyone around the world is able to try and log into my server. And that's actually what we see happening over here. Let's make an alert if that is happening multiple times from the same IP address. In order to do so, we go to Analytics, click on Add. So this is the place where we can configure a alert rule. A alert rule will generate a Azure Sentinel case. An Azure Sentinel case is a possible security incident. Let's see how we can configure it. First, let's give it a name. Multiple login attempts from the same IP. And we also use that as our description. The severity of this alert might be low. We have to execute a query. That query that's executed with a certain interval, and if it has a couple of results, there might be an alert generated out of it. I already made a query. Here it is, and what this query actually does, it will get results from the security event table. Where the activity starts with 4625, which is the code for the failed login attempt. And it summarizes the results by IP address and computer. So the result out of this query will be the name of the computer, the IP address of the hacker, and the amount of login attempts. And we made sure that the amount of login attempts need to be bigger than 3. So if a user tries to log in and he made a mistake by typing a wrong password, that event will not be in there and will not generate an alert. If he makes that mistake more than 3 times, the alert will be in there. We need to map some entities. We need to map the host, that's the computer name. We need to map the IP address, that's the IP address. We want to trigger an alert when there are more than one results out of our query. And we run it every 5 hours. Let's click on create. So now our rule definition has been created. So, and if we now go to cases, you'll see that there is a case in there. It has some evidence, there's one alert. And we see that the alert has generated through to the multiple await attempts rule. It's severity low. You can see even the query in there. I actually wanted to investigate the alert by now. So when I click on investigate, you'll see that there is a visual graph coming that will help you with the investigation. Azure Sentinel is still in preview. They are working on this feature right now. As soon as this is available, I will do definitely a new vlog about it. What you also actually want to have at this moment is an email or something that notifies you that your alert has been triggered. If we go to Azure Sentinel, we go to the analytics blade where we have configured our alert rule. You'll see that the response automation is coming soon. What Microsoft actually foresees is that when an alert is created, you can trigger a runbook, which is actually an Azure Logic app, and that will do some logic in order to email you about that event or trigger some other systems to automatically solve that event, etc. Unfortunately, that is where it now stops with Azure Sentinel. They are still in the development process. These features are coming soon. But there is a but, you can still get notifications when an alert is happening. As you saw when we got to the evidence of our alert, there is actually a query. And what you see over here in this query is that Azure Sentinel actually creates an entity in its log analytics workspace that there is an alert. And what we can do as IT admins, we can create our own logic app, query the log analytics workspace, and make sure that when an entry has appeared in the table, it will send us an email. And that is what I actually did. And this is what my logic app at this moment actually looks like. We have a recurrence. This logic app runs every 5 minutes. It will execute a query, which is picking up all the security alerts that have been generated in the past 5 minutes. And for each of the results of those query, it will send me an email to my email address. So in this vlog, we explored Azure Sentinel even more. We had a look at cases. We had a look at how we can set up alert rules in order to generate those cases. And what we actually wanted to do was generating alerts out of that case, out of cases. Azure Sentinel is still in development. Microsoft is working on the investigation blade of a case, and also automation that is triggered when an alert occurred is still in construction. I made a way around to get alerts into my mail. There is a workaround. We can create a logic app which is querying a log analytics workspace where all those alerts are stored and then send me an email. In the next vlog, I will dive deeper into dashboards, how you can create them by yourself. And yeah, maybe there is a third party vendor which can help us creating those dashboards. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one. If you like this one, please hit the thumbs up button. Also, subscribe to this channel and have a nice week. Bye.